Malinowski. Representative Salazar.
And thank you, Senator Cardin and Congressman Cohen and the Helsinki commissioners. And thanks for inviting me to testify at this critical hearing, and I agree with my colleague wholeheartedly. Corruption is a monumental threat to freedom and human rights. Many of today's dictators rule through corruption. I call them, and we have mentioned this word, kleptocrats, a fancy word for those who steal from their national treasury to enrich themselves. As you know, they plunder, they exploit, they rob their people with no mercy. In the process, they destroy the rule of law and use that stolen blood money to finance marketing campaigns that portray them as the saviors or redeemers of their country. I know it very well. Putin in Russia, Ortega in Nicaragua, Maduro in Venezuela, and Castro in Cuba. And for me, this is a personal tragedy. I have seen this devastation brought by kleptocrats to my most intimate surroundings. As you know, I am the daughter of political refugees who fled the Castro regime with the clothes on their back and $5 in their pocket. In 1960, Fidel Castro turned Cuba, an island with the same per capita income as Italy, into a fourth world satanic nightmare that lasts until today. As a foreign correspondent for the United States Spanish television, I reported and interviewed Chavez and Maduro. And those two thugs in only 20 years have turned the richest country in South America into a state where the average Venezuelan weighs 15 pounds less today because of lack of food. Venezuela inherited oil, but it also had Hugo Chavez. Chavez implemented his 21st century democratic socialism and promised to end political corruption, but instead, he created another class of even more corrupt, useful fools, as I call them, called los enchufados, the plugged ones. Another perfect example is Alice Saab, who stole millions and millions from an organization that was supposed to distribute food to people's houses in the most underprivileged barrios or neighborhoods in Venezuela. Meanwhile, Daniel Ortega from Nicaragua, he jailed my ex-husband, Arturo Cruz, who just running for president was his only sin. He was one of the presidential candidates in this last election. Arturo Cruz is currently in a military jail called Chipote, and Ortega just stole another presidential election. So along with fixing elections, Ortega, his family, and his friends took in $29 million in 2019 alone. So there is nothing these thugs fear more than a free election because they are in the business of power. They are not in the business of taking care of their own people. And as you said, these are not faraway problems for the United States. Corrupt money flooding our country also destroys American lives. The perfect example is the city of Miami, the city that I represent in Congress. Miami was a hotbed for laundering drug money in the 80s, and this brought violence that spilled into the streets and harmed innocent bystanders. On top of that, we got a very bad reputation with movies like Scarface and the television series Miami Vice. That's what kleptocrats do to our city. That is why I'm committed to fighting corruption, a fight that could not be more quintessentially American. We have already made enormous progress this Congress, and I am proud to be a founding member of the bipartisan Congressional Caucus Against Foreign Corruption and Kleptocracy. We are striking at three pillars of the counter-kleptocracy. We're keeping dirty money out of the United States, we're creating tools to dismantle these corrupt networks, and we're helping freedom fighters to build free societies abroad. I'm honored to testify and to work alongside my colleague, Tom Malinowski. Together, we have led several bills to fight dictatorship, as he just explained to you. We introduced the House version of Chairman Ben Cardin's bill called the Combating Global Corruption Act. This would create an open reporting system for all countries based on their compliance with anti-corruption norms and standards created by the United States. In the wake of the Pandora Papers investigation, Congressman Lonianowski and I also introduced the Enablers Act. This bill would require the private sector to question those profession enablers who help dictators to bring money into the United States to inform the federal government the source of that suspicious money. Business with our country is a privilege, is not a right. Their family members should not be allowed to travel, dine, and lavishly spend stolen money on our restaurants or our shopping malls. In other words, no more Saks or Broadway. By working together, Congress and this administration can block these murderous thugs from coming into our country. Thanks to you, to the efforts of the Helsinki Commission, we have recognized the existential nature of this threat, and we're responding with force. Thank you again for the opportunity to testify today in front of you, and I look forward to continue efforts to curb corruption and end brutal dictatorship and work across the aisle with members of Congress.